Prof Baxi, in the earlier video you spoke about your work for the Aborigines in Australia, and then when you were Dean in Delhi University, Dean Law, your association or your involvement in the matter concerning detention of Arun Jaitley and his desire to write the exam. Now, in this video, first I would like to ask you, what were the occasions and what is your impression, because you are known to have met Mrs. Indira Gandhi a number of times. Do tell us about those.
Well, it's a long time ago. I've written my book called The Supreme Court and in Politics. Yes. 7 or 8 pages, my account of work during the emergency. And this particular visit was on the eve of emergency. We did not know it was going to be declared. But we knew that she got a very difficult stay order from Justice Krishna Iyer, who was a vacation judge, who said that you can perform duties as Prime Minister, but you must
not vote.
All that kind of thing. So it was a qualified order, not a full order. And later on, I talked to Krishna. I used to call him Krishna. We all were very fond of him. We miss him. And as to why he passed that order, and he got a number of ideas about it. I won't go into that. But he did pass a qualified order. And there was a group of teachers in JNU, in Aligarh, in Delhi, who wanted to meet Mr. Gandhi on the occasion in support of her. And I had a pro-vice chancellor called Professor V.P. Dutt of Chinese Studies Department. And he persuaded the vice chancellor, Professor Rup Singh, that he must take this new professor, Dean of Law, with us to advise Mrs. Gandhi. So I had rheumatoid arthritis at that time in my knees and so on, so difficult for me even to walk and sit down. So I... They were a group of people committed to Mrs. Gandhi. They're the politics. I did not know that. I respect that, but I did not know that. I was very new. And I was sitting just like you, front to Mrs. Gandhi. I said, ma'am, and they asked me to speak first. And I said, I can't get up. I said, ma'am, I'm very sorry because I've got this problem. She said, no, you must stay seated. And then at that time, she had condemned the effigy burning near the house of a judge of Allahabad High Court, Jagan Mohan Sinha, who had given a judgment adverse to her on corrupt electoral practices, which disqualified.
That Raj Narayan's election petition.
Yeah.
Yes.
So Jagan Mohan Sinha's effigy was burned. So I said, first of all, I must congratulate you, ma'am, for doing this, for protesting. And she was very angry. You could see the
anger on her face.
I said, who told you that? And I didn't know what to do. So I said, my esteem for you rises even more if you condemn an act which did not happen. Because a lawyer, I believe in judicial, law teacher. In judicial independence. I'm glad you respect it. By which time, the people who asked me to speak first said to me, Don't go about this matters, just say what she should do now and support her, support the party, which was not my intention. I'm not supporter or opposed to any party. I'm not a political person. So I said, fair enough. I said only one thing, and I remember till this day. I said, Madam Prime Minister, you have been, you know what to do, you don't need my advice. You come from a family which has always believed in the constitution and its high tradition. And one can legally appeal against the stay of a vacation judge and have another trial. One can do one's best by the democratic cause of constitutionalism.
How did she react to that?
Very badly, I'm not for it. To be very angrily. I mean, I didn't say any word, but it's all right, Professor. And then, of course, all the others took over.
And there were other meetings too later on?
Other meetings, and that was after the emergency.
Okay.
Where there was, she indirectly asked me, I didn't meet her, about a special courts bill and act that Ram Jethmalani was responsible for. And I don't believe, and I've written in the Supreme Court and politics yes. book all about the special courts. I don't believe the special courts were justified. So she had sent her emissary to me. Then I met her. She also met her in Prema Bakshi, met her in some other political parties a number of times when I was in the office in Delhi University. So we had some relations on the whole. And she was a charismatic person. Only she didn't like what I said at one point of time.